All right, we're back in the shop tonight. Main reason we're out here tonight, I've been waiting a long time on these two parts, actually just the one part. But I finally got the cylinders to get this CNC back up and running. Probably the most commented thing, most of it was pretty negative. You know, folks are basically saying that can't maintain your own CNC machine. I'm telling you folks, that's just not true. You know enough about these, you know enough about industrial controls, you can. I've had this machine running for well over a year. And this is the first major issue that I've run into. So we're going to get to it. We're going to basically prove those folks wrong and get this cylinder remounted on the back. We're going to replace the, basically there's a gear cam in there that basically stops the tool carrier. As it comes around, it locks it in place. That's what we're replacing. This other cylinder that I got basically pushes the tool pot out. I don't have a leak in it right now that I know of, and I'm not going to replace it until I need to. But these are fairly long lead time parts. Both of these, they quoted me 4-week lead time. It took about, one took about a week. The other one took almost 2.5 weeks. So, it was something I needed to go ahead and get and take care of, and it wasn't a huge amount of money. Anyway, I'm gonna pull these out and kind of let you look at them. If you haven't seen the prior video of me taking this out, I'll try to put a card to it. And I'm gonna pull this out now. And just so you guys know, I guess SMC, they use Orange Coast pneumatics. Those folks are really easy to deal with. Again, you know, this is not a paid advertisement for them or anything, but I'll try to put a link or something to them in case you need an SMC part or an air cylinder part. They basically got the part numbers really quickly, usually the same day via an email, and the order process is really simple. And these come basically well-packed. So, this is our new cylinder. This is, I found a lot of cylinders that were really similar in specs. They did not have the same port. I believe this is a British style thread on both of these, and it's relatively large comparison to the cylinder. And this big metric bolt end is pretty hard to find. I was gonna have to make an adapter to make the other cylinder work. So if you remember my prior video, we took all this apart. I'm going to basically use this. I'm not going to use any of the old parts. Okay, step one, I've got the bolt that they provided taken off. I don't need that. This basically goes on. If you remember, it actually has four set screws, two per side. I'm going to put a little bit of a Loctite 680. It's just basically retaining compound to keep this, you know, any vibration or what have you from loosening this up a whole lot. But I'm going to take this over to the bench real quick. We got a little bit on the threads there. I'm going to screw this in. And then I'm going to tighten this down. I don't know if you'll be able to, yeah, you can see through it. But basically that goes all the way through, and there's actually two per side, one on top of each other. We'll get this screw back together. Okay, so we've got the assembly back together. Basically we put some green Loctite on the threads here. We've got our set screws back in place, and you can kind of see what this does here. This basically pops out and hits that carriage. It's a really short stroke cylinder. This is what I had to add. You can see there, you have to kind of get all this assembled and get thread sealing on it before you place it. The orientation of this is pretty simple. Basically goes like so. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to remount. There's a block here. I'm going to remount that to the block to kind of hold everything together. And then I'm going to start putting the screws in. And then we'll get the airlines hooked up, and we'll pretty much be ready to do a test. We'll air up the system and make sure that there's no leaks. Then we're going to do a little bit of calibration. This cylinder has flow valves to control how much flow is going through each airline on the return and the out. So I'll have to do a little bit of adjustment. I'm going to start off real slow. I'm going to get the machine in a state where that is the only thing that's moving. I definitely don't want it to do a full cycle because it's not going to move that cylinder when it needs to move it until I get that ratio set to where that cylinder can either move in and out really fast or it can move slow. And it should be kind of a gentle, kind of a kick. And I'm going to adjust these little valves here on the you saw it on the air fittings. Basically, they have a lock nut and a little thumb wheel, and you basically just screw them in and then lock it down. This is a time when you really don't want to drop a part. It's going to end up somewhere you don't want to have to dig around and get it out. Namely, coolant tank or the chip tray. Right now, the chip tray, I recommend if you're working on the machine, always clean up what you can. My chip tray is empty right now. But it is full of coolant, so I definitely don't want to let it get down that far if I can avoid it. Okay, so what I'm doing there, see that, how that's broke off? That's what broke off in the end, so got to just straighten that up. I probably need to replace the airline, but right now I'm not going to do that. That's something I can get to externally. Got it straightened out. Now I'm going to get something to clean these off, push them back into quick connect fittings. Okay, we'll see how this goes. The machine's set up at 90 PSI. I'm not going to mess with the rig. I'm going to go ahead and let it apply at full pressure. Worst case scenario, the line will pop loose and we'll figure out what we did wrong and put it back together. Okay, it holds pressure and I don't hear a leak anymore. So I think that was our leak, which is good news. We got a little bit of a mess to clean up. Just kind of get everything off the top of this machine. I don't want to start up the machine with stuff on the inside. That's a big no-no. But basically, I'm going to go through and do a safety check real quick. Make sure everything's okay. Nothing's in the way. We're going to leave this guard off for now. We're going to try out some tool changes after I actually adjust the velocity on this. Just looking at it right now, that when I first applied air, it probably took about half a second or so for it to like build, but when it went, it went. So I may need to actually trim those down just a little bit. But let me get this cleaned up, and we're gonna apply power and get this set up. I'm gonna home the machine. Okay, we got all the air leaks are sealed up. We don't have any air leaks now, at least not in while it's sitting still, which is a good sign. I've got the machine up. It's gonna be a little loud, I apologize. Got the rotary phase converter up and running. Got the machine booting now. I'm gonna get it into a mode where I can actually actuate the carousel. So that air leak's fixed. Now that I've got the machine actually up and it's actually, you know, turned on some of the solenoids, I found another air leak. It's gonna be right here in this fitting. The best way to find an air leak sometimes is just kind of hold your hand up and move it over the face of the machine. It'll actually kind of change and show you which direction the sound's coming from. I was able to spot this just by doing that right there. Just moving my hand over that. I don't know how well that's going to come through on camera, but it makes it really easy to spot acoustically. Anyway, I'm going to get that pulled loose. I think it's just leaking right at the connector. It's probably just it's an old nylon line. It's probably just needs to be cut off at the end and slid back in. At some point I need to replace it. I don't have that particular size, but I'm gonna get this fixed real quick and we'll keep moving forward. Okay, so this is a cylinder we just replaced. You can see the air lines going into this. I did reorient this. This was actually oriented up this way, but SMC sent this kind of already attached this way, and I figured that would be just as easy and I had plenty of room for the air lines. The offending next air leak is right behind this fitting. Grab this here and show you kind of where this goes. This basically goes here, and it actually connects up to this line, which has a sensor as well. And I basically have trimmed that up just to kind of try to solve the leak. It was kind of pinched in one area, and that's probably what's got this seal messed up, is this got pinched up in there. This will go up in there just fine. It just won't hold. It does snap. I can't get it to do it now, but anyway, when you apply air, it just slides right back off. And if you look up in there, there's little tabs that basically catch this hose. They're kind of lopsided and bent. Anyway. All right, so we got that last thing sealed up. I didn't think I was gonna find the right parts, but I was able to find a barb and actually get that connector sealed back up. And now we have a machine that doesn't have any air leaks when it's sitting still. Now I'm gonna go through the tool change just to make sure everything's working the way it should be. It's really nice that air compressor's not cutting on every 5 seconds. So let's give this a try and see how it works. Okay. I think I've got everything set up. This is good to go. I've got it in the tool change position. And now we get a really smooth tool change. Way smoother than it's ever been. It works exactly like it's supposed to. It's a lot quieter now. There's less air having to get actuated. I'm assuming probably since I had the machine, even when there wasn't idle air running through that cylinder, while the cylinder was moving, it was probably letting a lot of air escape and not moving as efficiently as it could. Now the cylinder change happens really easily, really fast. We'll just go here and we'll run an auto tool change. Let me make sure I've got enough air. Okay. And since I have not fully vetted everything on this, I still like to put the cover and everything on. I'll do that probably tomorrow. I'm gonna run this in single block mode. I highly recommend if you're working on the machine that you take every precaution you can to make sure you don't damage something. Okay, that was a good efficient tool change. Okay, that ran through the entire block. Okay, I'm gonna call that fixed. I still need to do a little bit of work back there on that line. I can kind of hear it hissing a little bit. I still wasn't able to replace that the angle connector, but I have a barb to a different type of pipe that actually fit a little bit better. But for right now, this works great. Okay, here's what this machine is supposed to look like when it's changing tools. So this is a new cylinder we just added. This is the airline that I just fixed, I hope. And I've actually got the cylinder that goes down in this tool pot change, which is actually up underneath here. I can kind of give you a view of it. You might be able to see it. It's right there. I've taken this cover off before. That cylinder is not leaking currently, so I'm not gonna replace it right now. But this is a tool change. Just kind of give you an idea of what that thing does. If you look down here at the tool carousel, it's literally stopping that tool carousel. I'll give you a little bit better shot of the controls here. So you've got, these are the controls right here. I made adjustments to these to get this nice smooth motion. I'll keep an eye on it. That's about as smooth as I can get it to operate, and it's reliable. Anyway, just wanted to kind of give you a quick shot of the finished work. This cylinder worked great. It was basically a drop-in replacement. Anyway, I hope you liked the video. If you have any comments, questions, if I can try to help you with a machine, I'll try to do the best I can. I'm mainly familiar with the Fanuc and Haas machines. But I'm really happy. I've got the machine back up and working. It's been several weeks now. It's probably the longest I've had the machine down. And I'm really glad to have it back up and working. And not leaking air. It has never run that good as far as air consumption goes. And that made a drastic improvement. If you've watched several of my other videos, that air compressor would have turned on already. Complaining, trying to supply air to this machine. Anyway. thanks. Hope you liked the videos. Please leave a comment. Please like and subscribe. See you on the next one.